Hi guys, I'm Catie Wayne and this is Animalist News. Although debated, most sci-fi fans agree that Godzilla acquired his massive size after being exposed to nuclear radiation. The question is, could that ever actually happen? Although 500,000 people were forced to leave their homes after the Chernobyl nuclear meltdown, animals continued to thrive in the area. Immediately after the disaster, Chernobyl went from a bustling city to a home for deer and boar. In the first years after the meltdown, scientists found stereotypical mutations such as dwarfism, strange growths, and glowing. However, these were only in plants. Despite having 2,000 times the amount of radioactive cesium-137, local wild animals look completely normal. But I wouldn't eat them if I were you. Cattle also seem to be pretty resistant to nuclear radiation. After the March 2011 earthquake and tsunami, thousands of cows were abandoned around the Fukushima Daiichi power plant. Although they've been contaminated by the radioactive materials being released from the plant, cows have no physical signs of mutation, but that isn't to say that they haven't been affected. After testing nearly 100 cattle from ground zero, scientists found traces of radioactive cesium, silver, and tellurium in their systems. Young calves have the highest concentrations of radiation because they have been born in the disaster zone. But at least those cows are still alive, others haven't been so lucky. So while I suppose a Godzilla-like situation could happen, it's astoundingly unlikely. What's your favorite sci-fi movie? I want to see that passion! I know you got it in you. Let me know in the comments below. Also, be sure to check out and Love Science with Elise Andrew, where she explores all things trending in science. She delves into interesting stories in chemistry, health, anatomy, and beyond, including stuff like this.
In a cave in Brazil, an insect has been discovered that has swapped genitals. When it's time to mate, the female mounts the male, inserts her gynosome into his vagina-like genitalia, and they begin a copulation session that lasts 40 to 70 hours.
Also, be sure to check out these videos over here and subscribe right now. I love you all, and I'll see you next time. Bye. Mwah.